Hey everyone, Martin here. I thought I'd give you a very simple Marble Machine X update in this video. Yesterday, I received the last big laser cut order. So all these parts lying on the table is the beginning to the end of this project. This is replacing the 3D prints sitting on the top of the machine there. Over here, we have the beginning to the new spring tension system. A really, really cool part coming from Henk Reichardt on cotterai.be is the custom made M5 rods. Shout out to Henk Reichardt, cotterai.be. Thank you so much, Henk and Joanna, for getting this to me so quickly. These rods will go through the holes of this piece. It's going to be amazing. Another project I've been working on is this marble pressure valves. So I've been experimenting with different internal marble paths. You can see one is straight and one is more zigzag. And I've been experimenting with a way here to see a pattern that will reduce the collected pressure for several marbles going down in a straight line. With the new design, we're gonna have a lot of marbles pushing on the marble gates, causing a lot of friction. So far, I'm running into quite difficult trade-offs between exactness of marble height and friction reduction. I call this for myself the final problem, just like the Sherlock Holmes book. I'm very, very close to the solution. This to me is kind of the last bastion of the Marble Machine X design process, I hope. So this is the link, and it sits with these spacers. The spacer goes there. That's gonna be like that. Chicka 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 chicka. Woot woot on that. I still don't know how this project will end. I feel very, very overwhelmed. Always been feeling overwhelmed for the last years in this project. It's like I've bitten off more than I can chew. There's just so many naive design decisions built into this machine. So when I try to fix the water leakage over here, the water sprouts out over there, leading to another 4 months iteration. I really don't know if I will pull this off. I'm trying to do some kind of genome transplantation of the DNA of the Marble Machine X, and I really don't know if it's enough. Let's find out. I think in most things worth pursuing, you don't have the answer before you go for it. That's just a part of this project. The uncertainty of it all also speaks of its potential value, I guess. Very, very good, nice words for I don't have a clue what I'm doing. But if you saw the episode from some weeks ago with the CAD team, my thoughts go more and more to the MMY, where we will be able to treat this physical machine as a prototype and design the whole machine digitally with no prototyping done in the real world. I learned so much about CAD designing in this project, so I think I can look at the digital CAD design and better judge how that will work in real life. It's going to be a really nice project together with the Elephant Eaters to keep on working on the MMY and see if we can take away some of the most naive solutions on the Marble Machine X. While I was waiting for all these parts to arrive, I used the time to organize my workshops and getting everything up and spick and span. I'm trying to develop some better organizational routines. You can watch my video about that that I put out earlier this week. Now I'm super excited to start with this, but tomorrow I'm going on my first vacation for 2020. I'm going to see my parents in Sweden, and I'm going to be there until the end of September. I'm going to make these 3 weeks a total break from the Marble Machine X. I'm going to think of other stuff, and then I'm gonna return in the beginning of October with new muscles to push this stone up the mountain. I really believe in this design. I just know from experience now, as soon as I fix something, something else has to be fixed. The good news is that all these projects is really easy to turn into videos. So I have some fun and nice and easy build videos to show you in October, definitely. In November, I think we should start to see if this is actually saving the Marble Machine X. It's funny how this project has affected me from being like naively super positive to everything. I've become super negative to everything. Not negative in that sense, but critical. And it was funny because when I started to talk to engineers, I thought they were just such downers, you know? You come like with a great idea and they were just shooting it down in 10 ways. And I'm like, why are you shooting my darling in the heart like with 10 bullets? Come on. Like, I always thought like experts were kind of narrow-minded. And I guess now that's exactly the role of an expert. Maybe now I am overly critical to my own solutions and I've lost all faith in my own ability of solving a single little problem. So maybe I'm overcompensating too far. Maybe 3 weeks break will awaken part of the naive, optimistic Martin again. I think so. It's going to be absolutely wonderful. I'm wearing a very fashionable Tjing cap today, and I'm not only grateful for the fact that I don't have to think about my hairstyle. By the way, I won't cut my hair until this machine plays music. That's why it's so long. Anyway, Tjing is a disc golf scoring app. If you never tried disc golf, this is like the best thing in the world. Seeing, if you didn't know this, you can actually create S curves with a flying disc. You can decide, I want to go 30 meters straight and then hard left, 40 meters straight and then slowly right. You can control so many ways. It's absolutely addictive. When I started playing disc golf, it was one of the best experiences in my life. I eventually made it to the Swedish championship for teams. I said no when they asked me because I wasn't good enough. And then I was like, okay, but can you be the reserve? And I was like, okay. And then it was a classical thing. Like on the morning of the Swedish championship, one guy breaks his legs, another guy gets the flu, and a third one was like, didn't find his car keys or something like that. So they had to call me. So like, Martin, you're in. And I'm like, no. So we went there. I lost my three matches, 11-0, 11-1, 11-0. The last match was against like a guy who took silver in European Championship against me. If you know in Jurassic Park, you know the goat. I was the goat. Tjing Disc Golf app is a super cool scoring app, and the graphic interface is just lovely. The simplicity is lovely. So I just wanted to give a shout out to my long-term friends, Jared and Hawk, from Tjing. Check out their app. That was a little update from me. I will be back in October and I wish you all a fantastic September, and I wish you good luck with everything you're doing, and I wish that you all find the balance between the naive optimism and the more down-to-earth critical thinking. If you can combine these two, you're on a good path. Take care and see you in October.